Thank you. worries and concerns. We want to wish him a happy birthday. He had a birthday this week. Oh, so we want to say happy birthday to him. Ready? One, two, three.
Happy birthday.
Good morning, everyone. This is the day that the Lord has made. Let us rejoice and have fun in it. And thank you for joining us this day here at Union United Methodist Church that we can worship together. I apologize for the tech problems that we've had this morning. This is literally a first for us that YouTube was not letting us connect our service even after three different attempts. So we moved to Facebook Live. I will attempt to upload the video and then share it on YouTube later for those of you who are not on Facebook. That's if I can, but I will attempt that after the service today. We're going to move into a time of prayer, and then we will engage God's word. Just a couple people we want to give a shout out to. First off, continue to lift up David Fisk, our brother in Christ, who is continuing to receive care and treatment at home, which his days, we don't know what tomorrow looks like, or the next week, or the next month. It's very uncertain, but he is still very alert and loves company and loves God, and just taking a day at a time. Please give them some love and keep him and his family in your prayers. The other person we want to lift up is Matt, whose last name escapes me, and I apologize. It's Jackie Groom's son-in-law. He has been diagnosed with a terminal cancer, and he's, I think, 35 years old, and they just found out this week. So the family is devastated, giving it to God, and so shall we. So please keep Matt and his wife, Mary, in your prayers. Know that God loves them, we love them, and we are lifting them to God. Let us pray together. Dear Heavenly Father, thank you for always being ready to hear us before we are ready to pray. And we do lift up all of our brothers and sisters and ourselves into your care. Send the peace of your Holy Spirit down upon the families that we have remembered and named this day, that they may feel your love, that they may feel your presence, and we pray that you do a mighty work in their lives. In the name of Jesus, we pray. Be with all of those that we have also lifted in our hearts, and for our brothers and sisters at home who are also praying, God, we pray with one heart. We pray with one voice. Hear us and give us ears to listen as you answer. And we thank you, God, for answering our prayers. We lift them all to you in Jesus' name, who taught us to pray using these words of the Lord's Prayer. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen.
Hear you whisper underneath your breath.
everybody else behind the scenes was able to be here today, and we are enjoying tuning in with everybody back home. Lord, please open our minds and our hearts as we receive this message in your precious and holy name, I pray. Amen.
Amen.
The scripture lesson for this morning comes from Paul's letter to the Philippians, chapter 4, verses 1 through 9. Hear now the word of God. Therefore, my brothers and sisters, whom I love and long for, my joy and crown, stand firm in the Lord in this way, my beloved. I urge Euodia and I urge Syntyche to be of the same mind in the Lord. Yes, and I ask that you also, my loyal companion, help these women, for they have struggled beside me in the work of the gospel, together with Clement and the rest of my co-workers whose names are in the book of life. Rejoice in the Lord always. Again, I say rejoice. Let your gentleness be known to everyone. The Lord is near. Do not worry about anything. But in everything, by prayer and supplication, with thanksgiving, let your requests be made known to God. And the peace of God, which surpasses all understanding, will guard your hearts and your minds in Christ Jesus. Finally, beloved, whatever is true, whatever is honorable, whatever is just, whatever is pure, whatever is pleasing, whatever is commendable, if there is any excellence, and if there is anything worthy of praise, think about these things. Keep on doing the things that you have learned and received and have heard and have seen in me, and the God of peace will be with you also. This is the word of God for us, the people of God. Thanks be to God. Will you pray with me? Heavenly Father, may the words of my mouth and the meditations of our hearts be worthy in your sight, O God, our rock and our redeemer. Amen. In studying the scripture, a particular song came to my mind, and I have heard it a couple times on the radio in the last couple of weeks. Especially when you hear the words, do not worry, don't worry. What's the reply to that in song form? Don't worry, be happy. Yes, that I grew up with that song, and it's catchy, and it sticks in my head. And it gives the advice that, you know, we have enough to worry about in this life, you know, but just be happy anyway. If you hear the song lyrics, though, sometimes you're like, really? You're going to try to be happy anyway? It starts with you have no place to lay your head. Someone came and took your bed. I would be worried about that, but no, it's be happy. Or the more amusing line that the landlord says your rent is late. He might have to rhyme so well, litigate, but don't worry, be happy. I don't know. I think worry is a national pastime of ours. Worrying is what we do, and in the terrible phrase of it's 2020, we have plenty to worry about. Of course, we also know that if we let ourselves worry in a frenzy, that is extremely unhealthy. So we can take that to the other extreme and fake our happiness, that we will be optimistic and joyful as much as we can and put that smile on our face even though it is false. And that can be just as dangerous as letting ourselves worry to death, because then we're lying to ourselves and not dealing with the problems that we're faced with. Do we give space for worry? And also, with the true things we worry about these days, are we giving each other space to be genuinely happy? As I've shared with you before in Paul's letter to the Philippians, that there is a lot of turmoil and suffering and pain happening in their lives right now, for Paul in prison and tortured, and for a church that is literally being persecuted. We have many, many reasons to be worried. So, How do we manage this? How are we going to deal with our anxieties? And also find space of where we can be joyful? Well, let's follow Paul's advice. Rejoice. It's not joy, but it's pretty much the same word. Rejoice in the Lord. Sounds like a great inspirational quote you can share on social media. Rejoice sounds great. Then Paul adds a word, always. Do you feel like being joyful all the time? Especially right now in 2020? No, not me either. Sometimes I'm really frustrated. The internet has given us lots of frustration today, YouTube especially. I don't always want to be joyful. Sometimes I want to be mad. Especially over the things I cannot control. So Paul, what are you doing here? Rejoice always? I don't want to be joyful always. He continues. Rejoice in the Lord. Always, again, I say, rejoice. Let your gentleness be known. And that's a good thing. Gentleness sounds a little passive, though. So I'm pulling up on my phone here. The Message translation, which I think could be very helpful. Let me pull it up here. Verses 4 and 5. Celebrate God all day, every day, and I mean revel in Him. Make it clear as you can to all you meet that you are on their side, working with them and not against them. Help them see the Master is about to arrive. He could show up in any minute. Oh yeah, I left out that word, didn't I? In the translation, let your gentleness be known to everyone. The Lord is near. Do you really want to be gentle with everyone? For that guy who cut you off in traffic? For that politician who put out the latest angry attack ad? Which maybe you like that, or you're the opposite? Or the person who has betrayed your trust? Or just that relative that you can't get along with? Be gentle with them, everyone. Paul's giving us some very big words here. Rejoice in everything. Be gentle to everyone. I don't know about you, but this is starting to grate me a little bit. Especially when we have plenty to worry about. And then it goes on. Do not worry about anything. Don't worry, be happy. But in everything, by prayer and supplication with thanksgiving, let your requests be made known to God. Maybe we could be okay with that. Because Paul's giving us a little bit of a move here. We may worry about a lot. We may worry about everything. What do we do with it? Give it to God. All of it. There's some great commentaries that describe this as literally banging on the door of heaven with a loud voice. Sometimes our prayers are, you know, passive and quiet and sweet and, you know, full serenity. And that's nice. That's good. But sometimes when we pray, we need to be banging on the door of heaven loud and let it be known. Tell God exactly how you feel. Give Him everything. And then the peace of God, which surpasses all understanding, will guard your hearts and your minds in Jesus Christ. There is something here that helps the joy be found. How can Paul, in imprisonment and in torture, rejoice at anything? How can the church under persecution rejoice, find joy, and be gentle to everyone and everything? How can we in 2020 be the church and be frustrated and tired and angry, but yet we are being called to be gentle and to show that we are on their side and to rejoice, have joy in everything? It starts here. Starts here in the prayer. You're giving your worry to God. The joy comes in knowing that God has heard your prayers. The joy comes that God is answering your prayers. And the joy comes further when we have been reminded or perhaps reconnected in relationship that we are one with God and with each other. And it's from this space comes joy. Paul continues, finally, beloved, whatever is true, whatever is honorable, whatever is just, whatever is pure, whatever is pleasing, whatever is commendable, If there is any excellence and if there is anything worthy of praise, keep thinking about these things. What Paul is reminding us is that in all the anxiety and real worry and fear and frustration, 2020, in the year 60-70, there is more than enough of these qualities of the Spirit, which is honorable and just and pure and pleasing, commendable and excellent, worthy of praise. It's not that we're looking for diamonds in the rough. There is more than enough because God gives out of his abundance. And out of that abundance and out of that presence and community, there is reason to rejoice. And I'm okay with that. The big words can frustrate me. To rejoice always, even when YouTube wouldn't let us connect. Yes, I am having a grudge on that. I'll get over it. But all the other reasons to be frustrated. To rejoice always, to be gentle with everyone. Yeah, that sounds hard. It's not hard for God. And know that being called in community as the church, we do not suffer alone. We do not hold one another alone, that we are one in the Spirit, where we are one with God. And therefore, we have the space and the gift and the good news to rejoice in everything, to be gentle with everyone, that we can take all of our joy and all of our frustration to God at the same time. And that God will listen and God will answer. And we know by faith our prayers have been heard. And therefore we can keep rejoicing and praising and giving thanks. As Paul can, even in the midst of suffering. As we can and should in the midst of suffering. So that the good news may be shared. That the good news may be received. And that people may see God. Hear verse 9 again. Keep on doing the things that you have learned and received and have heard and seen in me, and the God of peace will be with you. We all pray for the presence of the God of peace these days too, especially. So may we give the God of peace by rejoicing in everything. Yeah, and we can do that. Not faking it, but knowing that God is with us, that we may be gentle with everyone, that even God is gentle with us, even as we bang on the door with our frustrations, he receives us, so that we may receive each other in gentleness and in love. May these words that seem very large and impossible for us, but not are impossible for God, be the good news for you and I today. Thanks be to God, and let us pray. Almighty God, it's hard not to be frustrated and tired and weary these days. And even when we are tired and weary, you receive us and you are with us. Paul gives us the gift to give everything to you. Not just our joy, but our anger and our frustration. Help us, God, to give it to you and bang on the door. Knowing that you have heard us and that you are answering. And that in this communication, relationship is restored with you and one another, that we may be the church, that we may be the church in these troubled times. Bless us, God, so that we may be gentle with each other, and that we may show and share all that is good and right and worth remembering, knowing that they're not, your gifts of the Spirit are not just hidden away. They're here in abundance. They just need to be shared, because there's more than enough good in this world to overwhelm all evil. Help us, God, to share this good news and of community and sharing the peace of Christ so that in these troubled days, your light may shine brighter. We pray this in Jesus' name. Amen. You. For joining us for worship today. For those of you who are not on Facebook, so you're like, how am I seeing this? Okay, for those of you on Facebook, you may be hearing, I couldn't see the service. I'm going to attempt to upload this video for a debut on YouTube so you can watch it that way so that everyone can be part of our service. Reminder, next week we will be in lawn chairs outside. The weather's supposed to be clear, hopefully no tropical storms, and we can worship together outdoors and safely and be the church then. So Thank you so much for worshiping with us. Let's have a prayer and then we'll go in his name. Let us pray. Dear God, we thank you for giving us the gift of joy. It's the fruit of your spirit. Thank you for giving us the gift of gentleness, that we may be kind to one another in these times of where it's hard to be kind and gentle. Thank you for giving us the gift of your church, that we may work together, labor together, be the kingdom together, and knowing that we are not alone. Thank you for giving us the gift of prayer, that we may lift up to you our joys and our fears and worries to you, so that indeed we can be happy because you are with us, and as a church we are together. Help us to share this good news of people who are truly lonely and afraid and angry, that they may receive these blessings of the Spirit that we have experienced today. We pray this in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen.
And all the earth will shout your